Hi, in this video I am going to show you how to digitize an applique letter file like this for free using free software and using any font that you want and any size you want, and you will be able to save out an embroidery design that your machine can stitch out. So let's get to it. Hi guys, we are in Inkscape, which is a free vector-based drawing tool. It's really awesome. So what I'm going to show you today is I'm going to show you how to create a letter applique. So it starts by just using our type tool. So we're going to go ahead and click the type tool, and then we're going to click a letter. So I'm just going to make a J because that's my favorite. And then I am going to make it quite a bit bigger because this is going to be an applique and I want the J to fit in my 4" by 4" hoop. So I just selected the J. Now if I wanted to change the font, that would be over here in the T menu, or the T panel, which is gives me all of the control to change different text styles. I'm just going to keep it what it is, and then I'm going to drag on these arrows to scale it. Now if I just drag without holding down the shift key, it's going to be disproportionate. So if I hold down shift, I will be scaling it up proportionally. So I'm just going to do something like this. And then let's take a look at the size. Because I am American, I think in inches. So I'm going to change this up here to inches. And I can see that this is 3.7 inches wide and 3.8 inches high, which is will fit perfectly in a 4" by 4" hoop. So we're just going to keep it as is. Now let's go over to our layers and objects panel over here, and I can see that this is Inkscape thinks of this as text. We want it to think of it as an object. So what I need to do is go to the object menu, and path menu, and I'm going to say object to path. Now this is no longer considered text, it's just a path, but it's inside of this group, which I don't want. So I'm going to do one more thing, and I'm going to say object, pop selected objects out of group. Okay, I don't need this empty folder. I'm going to delete it, delete, and now I just have this path. Now I could rename it if I want to, but I don't need to. So I am going, right now it says there's the fill and the stroke are unset. So I have my object selected. I'm going to choose a stroke down here, and it doesn't matter what color, I'm just going to pick any color. Well, that's the fill. So we want the fill, we'll go to the stroke, and we'll give the stroke a color, and we're going to say stroke style dashed. Okay, that's pretty big dashes, doesn't really matter too much. I can make them smaller. These are the width. We don't want them to be that wide, so let's just make them 1 millimeter wide so it looks a little bit better. And I can make the length longer if I want, but I don't think it really matters actually for what I'm going to do with this. Okay, let's get rid of the fill. So we're going to say no fill, and the stroke paint, it wants to make it black, but we want to get it a better color. I think it's easier, you know, we're in the CMYK selectors. So let's add some magenta, some yellow, some cyan. Okay, so now we have it a color, which is great. Okay, now let's go back to our objects area. And I have this one object, path 350, and it has no fill, but just a stroke of dashed lines. That's great. Okay, so let's take that, and I'm going to say edit, copy, edit, paste in place. Now I have two paths on top of each other. Let's change the stroke color of this second one. Okay, so we will select it. We can change it down here. We'll pick stroke and we'll make it another color. Oh, that's the fill. We don't want the fill. Sorry, fill, nothing, stroke, something. Okay, so this is a different color than... Did I make it a different color? Let's see. So I have this one. Let's turn it off for now. Okay, two different colors. It's a little bit subtle, but... let's make it real different. Okay, So now we have two different colors. So we are making a raw edge applique design, right? So our first one, when we save it out as an embroidery file, let's go back to our object list. Our first run here, we want just to be a simple dashed line. The next one, we want to be a triple stitch or a bean stitch. So in order to do that, I have to select it, and then I'm gonna go to extensions, ink stitch params, okay? And once I choose that, then I have to put in here the number one for bean stitch number of repeats, okay? And I'm gonna say apply, and I can make that longer if I want to or not, the stitch length. But let's just say, actually 2 millimeters is what I really like. So let's just change that here, and we'll say apply and quit. Now let's file, save as, and it gives me the opportunity to save it in a whole bunch of different formats. Here's PES file, that's very popular. I can open it right from here on my Brother machine. So I'm gonna say new J applique from Inkstitch. Now we're gonna go and take a look at it stitched out. So I'm putting in my downloads. But first, let's just open it in Embrilliance and preview the stitch out of that PES file. So I'm gonna say file, open, and I'm going to choose my downloads, new J. Okay, so let's take a look. So we see we have two objects here, and let's use our stitch simulator. The first object is our triple stitch, which is not what we wanted. We wanted to do the running stitch first for our placement, but that's okay. So we see this is the triple stitch because it's gonna take a long time to stitch. And then we get to here, and that's just the simple running stitch, right? So what do we need to do? No big deal. Let's stop this, we'll close it, go back to ink stitch, and we need to change the order of these two. So let's move this after that, okay. And now file, save as. And we can resave it as what it was before. Save, replace, okay. And now let's go to Embrilliance and we will open that PES file. And let's take a look at it now. Our two different objects here. And nope, I don't want to go into create mode. I want to, now we have the running stitch first. And then when we, the next thread color is the triple stitch. So that's how I make my file. Now let's see what it looks like stitching it out. Here you can see I have a hooped piece of sticky back stabilizer, and I've stuck some fabric on there, and I'm starting to stitch out my first thread color, and that is just my placement stitching. So when that's done, I simply lay down my prepared applique fabric over that placement stitch line and then start stitching that next thread color. And this is my bean stitch. When this is done, I remove the hoop from the embroidery machine and I just trim around that bean stitch line, leaving a little bit of a raw edge. And then my applique is done.